Now, let's run a simple next-gen code app. For this demo, we will use CSDE. CSDE is the CODA standard development environment. The CSDE is obtained by cloning the CSDE template from the GitHub repo. You will find the link to this template in the video's description. I've already cloned it to my local system. The CSDE provides a ready setup which you can run as a starting point to develop your own prototypes. It also provides you a set of Gradle tasks which speed up and simplify the development and deployment process. Using CSDE, we will see how to deploy a local CODA cluster with Combine Worker. We will see how to build a CPK, CPB, CPI file. We will then see how to install a CPI on the CODA cluster, and then we'll create a virtual node and register it with MGM. And finally, we will run a flow and print the output. As a prerequisite to CSDE, you need the CODA CLI installed on your system, and you would also require Docker Postgres. For this demo, we will see how to write a token CODA app. We will have two parties, issuer and the owner. The issuer will issue a token worth some X amount to the other party. Once the token is issued, we will verify the same by hitting both the parties' database. You can find the link to the token CODA app in the video's description. Looking at the directory structure, we can see that we have the contract and the workflow directory. Your contract and states will go over here, and your flows will go over here. Let's first begin by deploying a local combined worker CODA cluster on my local system. So to do this, I will hit the start CODA Gradle task. Let's do that. So what it does is, it basically downloads the combined worker and JDBC Postgres SQL driver to your home directory. And then it starts off a local JVM combined worker process at port 8888. So if you look over here and if you run a ps grep command over CODA combined worker, you should see that a combined worker has started. If you also look at the home directory, you should see that a CODA 5 directory gets created. If you look into that, the CODA combined worker and the JDBC drivers have been installed or have been downloaded in this particular directory. By default, the combined worker uses the database as an emulated message bus, which basically uses Postgres as the database. This means that Kafka is not required for day-to-day development and testing. Now let's check if our combined worker has started by hitting the Swagger API. So as you can see, the Swagger API is up. So that means our combined worker is started off and the local combined worker cluster is started. The quick deploy Gradle task, it combines all of the five Gradle tasks mentioned over here. And this lets you start the cluster in seconds. So overall, these tasks, they do two major things. One, it builds the CPI and uploads the CPI to the local worker cluster. And two, it creates and registers the virtual nodes. Let's run the quick deploy task. The quick deploy task creates a CPI file in the workflow directory. Now let's try to open this file. So if we open this file, you will see that we have something called as the group policy.json file. Now, this file, it consists of certain information of a particular network. It consists of a unique group ID. This basically links the CODA app inside the CPB bundle to a specific network. It also consists of the static network field, which basically lets you start off a static network in your local CODA cluster deployment. As you can see, the static network, it consists of Alice, Bob, and Charlie. These identities have been taken from the configuration file, which you set over here. So you can add and delete identities to the static network file by making changes to this file. Now internally, to create the CPI file, we use the Corda CLI tool. CPI is uploaded to the network by calling the HTTP RPC API, which is the slash CPI call. Now let's run the list CPI, and you should be able to see the list of available CPIs. Now let's talk about virtual node creation and registering the virtual nodes to MGM. The quick deploy Gradle task, internally, it uses the HTTP RPC API to create the virtual node by passing in the X500 name and the CPI file checksum. The CPI file checksum is created when we upload the CPI file to the local Corda cluster. But the virtual node is still not useful until everyone on the network knows about this node. Now, hence, what we have to do is we need to register the virtual node to MGM, where the virtual node will request the MGM to join the network. Once the MGM approves, this node will be able to participate in the network transactions. So now the cluster is up, the CPI has been uploaded to the cluster, virtual nodes have been created for Alice, Bob and Charlie, and each virtual node represents an identity, a Corda app and a network group ID. Now let's take a look at the components of a Corda app. So to build any Corda app, we require, as I mentioned, three basic things: a state, contract and a flow. To write a state in Corda, write a class and implement it with the contract state interface. All the properties which you want to make sure that what you see is what I see will go as a part of the state. Hence, we've added issuer, owner and amount as the properties to this state. The contract state interface, it consists of a participant field. All the identities which should be notified of the state changes will go as a part of the state. To write a contract in Corda, write a class and implement it with the contract interface. It consists of a verify method. We call this method via the flow, where we pass in the transaction proposal to this method. A transaction proposal can be verified against certain set of rules which are written in the contract. Now let's take a look at the flow. This is the flow class. To make sure it can be hit via an HTTP RPC API, implement it with the RPC startable flow interface. We inject the relevant services for our flow. So for example, we inject the JSON marshal service, which is used to marshal and unmarshal from the input JSON to DTO and vice versa. We've injected member lookup so that we'll be able to access the other members on the network. We use the ledger service to access the ledger in our Corda cluster. We use notary lookup to access the notary. And flow messaging will be used to initiate communication with the counterparties. In this flow, what we'll do is we will create a transaction proposal, and then finally we will call the finalize method. The finalize method internally will sign, verify, collect signatures and record and broadcast a signed transaction to the involved counterparties. This signed transaction will be saved to the relevant counterparties database. Let's now hit the flow. Let's hit the token issuance flow from Alice to Bob. Let's use the HTTP RPC API to hit the flow from Alice's virtual node. So you have to provide Alice's virtual node's ID. Let's take Alice's virtual node ID by running the list virtual nodes Gradle task. So let's copy Alice's virtual ID. Let's paste it over here. Let's also provide the required input to this particular flow. So I'm saying that for this specific client, I want to run this flow on Alice's virtual node, and I want to issue an amount worth 101 to Bob. Let's execute this flow. Now it says that the request has been initiated. Now let's take the same virtual node ID, and let's take a look at what's the status of our flow. So let's copy the virtual node ID and let's also copy the client ID. So as you can see that the flow is completed. Now let's hit the list token flow and let's retrieve the issued token from Alice's database. So let's take the input request from here. So now we are basically hitting the list token flow to the same virtual node. And we are saying that for this specific client ID, can you retrieve the tokens which are available in the database? So let's execute this. You will see that the flow has started. And now again, let's again take this client ID and let's retrieve the result for this specific flow using the get call. So for the same virtual node ID, I'm interested to know what's the output of this specific flow which ran with this specific client ID. So let's execute this. So now if you see that the flow has completed and this is the token which was issued from the issuer to the owner. Here you can see that the issuer is Alice and the current owner is Bob. And the amount of token which was issued was 10. Now you can execute the same flow, which is the list token flow from Bob's virtual node. And then you can see if the token has been created on Bob's database as well. So let's do that. Let's take Bob's virtual node ID. And let's fire the same request for Bob's virtual node. So let's execute this. Now we can see that the request has started. Now let's retrieve the result for Bob's virtual node. And now you can see that Bob also consists of the same token details in its database as well. Now let's also take a look at the database of Charlie. So let's take his virtual node ID. And let's see if the token is present in his database as well. So let's execute the list token flow for Charlie. Then now you can see that the request has started. And now let's retrieve the result for Charlie. Now you can see that the database is empty for Charlie. So even though Charlie was present in the same cluster as Alice and Bob, he was not even aware that such a transaction took place.